Mr. Deputy Chairman, I think that it will be generally agreed that a bill of this type is almost unavoidable at the present stage. There may be differences about some measures and also about the extent to which the government proposes to go. That some physical control would be necessary at this stage when we are having development programs on a very large scale, a good part of which would be financed through deficit financing, will, I hope, be uncontested. I think the fact that in the 11th five-year plan, the greatest emphasis has been placed on heavy industries, especially on the production of certain types of capital goods, lends further force to an argument of this type. I am aware that the 11th five-year plan has also provided that there will be an expansion in consumption, but I have no doubt that the greater emphasis on capital goods will result in at least a temporary shortage in consumer goods, and this may lead to further inflationary pressures to a certain extent. Such pressures have already been felt. The recent rise in prices is a kind of warning of the kind of situation that may develop unless we are careful from the very beginning. Therefore, I would say that this measure of the government, in so far as I can understand it, has a twofold aim. On the one hand, to increase the capacity of the Reserve Bank for creating money by note issue, and on the other hand, to put restrictions on the creation of credit by private banks. The first aim is intended to ensure that the money that is required for the economic development of the country will not be lacking. The second is to see that unregulated creation of credit by private scheduled banks will not create a situation whereby inflationary pressures would become too great. To that extent, everybody would agree that a bill of this type is unavoidable. I have, however, a few questions to ask of the Honorable the Finance Minister, and I have no doubt he will be able to meet the doubts which I have in my mind. My first doubt is whether there is not an undue measure of fear about these inflationary pressures. In the 11th plan, there is an uncovered gap of rupees 400 crores, and there is also a proposal to have rupees 1200 crores of deficit financing, and so we may say that deficit financing would be of the order of rupees 1600 crores, because after all the uncovered portion has to be met somehow or the other. I do not know whether sufficient credit has been taken of a possible adverse trade balance which is bound to develop during the first 2 or 3 years of the 11th 5-year plan. We are going to industrialize on a fairly heavy scale, and as we import machinery on a large scale, an adverse balance of trade is bound to develop. This adverse balance of trade will, to a certain extent, act as a check against any inflationary pressures. Then again, there is the question of production of food grains and other materials within the country. Our economy is an expanding economy at the moment, and I think that by the end of the first year of the 11th plan or sometime during the second year of the 11th plan, many of the measures which were undertaken during the 10th plan shall start yielding results. Many of the major irrigation objects will give full dividends, and the production of food grains in the country is bound to go up. As the production of food grains goes up within the country, it will again be a check on inflationary pressures. Also, some of the industries which were established during the 10th plan will start yielding results. From this point of view, I would also like the Honorable Finance Minister to consider whether the pattern of deficit financing which has been adopted in the 11th 5-year plan is sound or may require some modification. To my mind, it appears that the decision to the maximum amount of deficit financing in the first year of the 11th 5-year plan is not appropriate. Perhaps it would be a wiser thing to put the maximum amount in the second year of the 11th 5-year plan, because by that time the factors which I have mentioned to now will have come into operation. There will be more production of food grains within the country. Some of the results of industrialization during the 10th 5-year plan begin to be felt, and as there will be a larger volume of commodities of every type in the country, a larger dose of deficit financing in the second year of the 11th 5-year plan may prove a more salutary measure than the decision to have the largest dose in the first year. There is another reason why I am a little comprehensive to have the biggest dose of deficit financing in the
first year of the 11th five-year plan. If the inflationary process starts, if once there is any disturbance in the psychology of the market, the results are difficult to foresee. If therefore in the first year of the 11th plan we proceed a little more and have the biggest dose in the 10th year and perhaps a little less in the third, and then tightening up and reduce the deficit financing, I have 3 years, the third, fourth and the fifth of the second plan both to watch and to take such remedial measures as may be necessary. This is a suggestion which would like the Honorable Finance Minister to consider. I am continuing it here because I think it has a definite relevance to the proposal he has made for currency expansion by doing away with the ratio between the bullion and the securities.